Officials of the Electoral Commission appeared before the Legal and Parliamentary Affairs Committee of Parliament to explain the impasse surrounding the LC1 and LC2 elections plus women council elections, which were supposed to take place last year.
We have currently 71,230 villages in the whole country. 71,230 villages. We also have 10,717 parishes. 10,717 parishes. This is now, these are the electoral areas for LC1, LC2. Then women also.
We want to find out whether EC has ever made an effort to interact with Minister of Finance relating to the issue of funding, and what feedback did they get from Minister of Finance.
However, the chairperson of the Electoral Commission, Simon Peter Byabakama, told the committee that before they called off the Women Council elections at the last minute, 21 billion shillings had already been spent on preparatory activities.
For women, we did so because we were mindful of the timeline under the law, and we had been promised, one by this August House or committee, that would get the necessary funds and also assured that funds would be available for us to conduct these elections.
We are in 2023 and discussing elections that should have been held in 2022. In 2027, we may be here discussing parliamentary elections that are naturally due in 2026.
15.6 billion, 20 something. And you're asking for more. Is it because of the size of the villages? I know that the villages increased, but maybe you could also tell us about that, because many people's villages did increase.
The Electoral Commission says they need 58 billion shillings to conduct women council elections and LC1 as well as LC2 elections, which will save the government another loss of funds. Byabakama demonstrated efforts they have undertaken as the entity to look for funds from the Minister of Finance, but all in vain.
Before the close of the financial year, we had a two-hour meeting with the Secretary to the Treasury, and we laid on table all our requirements. As Honorable Fox Odoi has said, we also brought to the attention of the Secretary that we are tenants. We are now tenants. We are no longer bananyini. In our swamp, we are owners, but we are no longer owners.
But committee members expressed disappointment, wondering why government has not treated LC1 and LC2 like a priority in the country.
I really thought maybe the major key stakeholders like local government, finance, most certainly would be here. I don't want to make allegations. Is it possible that maybe government is not interested in these elections?
The electoral process of LC1, then you refer back to the Electoral Commission. Electoral Commission will also push to finance. Finance will push to president. At the end of the day, we are there in question marks.
Report compiled by Fred Kajivi for the news at Parliament.